I think what it's forced us to do is rapidly upskill, which is a great thing in terms of, you know, emergent technologies and how we deal with the online space. The other great thing that I think it's done is also forced leadership and management to shift their perspectives, particularly archaic sort of beliefs around presenteeism, because everybody has been forced to work from home and we're suddenly a global remote workforce. And we've proved that it can work. So the trust levels, particularly that we're seeing coming out of sort of our research in asking people about their experiences, is that they feel incredibly trusted. So that is core to sort of the success of any productive workforce, if you like. So it's a great thing that we need to focus on and foster, I think, moving forward. It's increased our empathy and understanding and inclusivity. So the fact that we are now fully flexible across time zones, across geographies, across mediums in which we sort of communicate means that a lot more opportunities are accessible to people. So whether that be tapping into a global workforce, whether that be just finding new knowledge and tapping into things online and that sort. But also it's sort of, the downside obviously is that people need to put a boundary down. So I think we have seen an increase in working hours that's been reported recently, and again that's just going to be a behavioural adjustment that people will have to do if this is to continue. But the newfound flexibility that we have discovered in terms of organising our lives, how we do our most productive work and when, and the freedom to do that is a great thing that's really emerged out of COVID-19, I'd say.
How we're working is sort of accelerating. So what has happened in the past is that we already had some sort of applications. We were already working online. This is not entirely new. But what you see is this sort of change has accelerated over the past few months. And suddenly, for a lot of people who could not imagine that they would be working online and having virtual meetings, everything has changed and is happening now online and virtual. And people who were very critical are now very accepting. And suddenly we run meetings for 300 people all online. People can ask questions, we have town halls, and we find it normal. And so that we've never seen such a quick shift, I think. The second thing is what work means to us. So a lot of people have lost their job, are at risk of losing their job. And so suddenly we start considering how valuable that job still is and the sort of identity that we get from the job. But at the same time, even people that are not losing their jobs, they're sort of reflecting on, this was a major crisis, a health crisis, an economic crisis, and they're sort of reflecting, is this what I want from my job? How will the future look like? And so people are thinking about the purpose, the identity they get from their jobs, and about their future work selves. And I think then the third thing is how we manage work. We used to have ways of sort of managing people like it were resources, and that meant that we are treating everyone the same, we have structured policies. And what is happening now is that we discover that actually people have different preferences, work in different ways, and productivity, there's no uniform recipe for productivity. And so what we see is a sort of, we're treating people more as individuals, giving them more autonomy and more flexibility. And so the way organizations are structured, that is quickly changing now, and we sort of give more autonomy to people, they become more entrepreneurial, the teams are more self-steering, and so that is another way how work is changing.